We ain't got to do much. We can Netflix and chill and get pimp and roll up and get drink and pour up and get lit and tow up till we spit and throw up. But so what? I'm with you. Who really cares? Gives a fuck. Hold up. You my favorite lady. Even though sometimes you know you drive a nigga crazy. Even though sometimes you make me argue over simple things. I appreciate you cause you appreciate the simple things I do for you. And you will never take the boy for granted. And you get all attention cause your presence is commanding. And when you in the building, all the women can't stand it. And I just need some more time, baby, I demand it. God damn it.
Got love fast, yeah. But I'd rather just you and you. Eating on the hot ties, I can blow them up fast. But I'd rather just you and you. And we could watch a movie, chillin' with you. We gon' have to blow this hour, this. Chillin' with you. Get the liquor, get the drinkin'. Couple shots, take a few.
Yeah. You're now tuned into $1 million worth of game. I'm Wallo 267.
I'm Gillie,
this is
the
Gillie
king.
The nut. No, you're a nut. You're a nut. You're a nut. Your name Gillie the nut. I introduce you.
No,
I introduce you.
Hold up.
And right over here, we got our producer, the one and only Dev Nasty, aka MySpace Dev.
We ain't doing none of that shit.
What are you talking about?
Gillie
the nut.
Introduce me.
I introduce you. You're a nut.
You introduce.
Listen, man. All that stuff.
Fuck is he talking about?
Ooh.
Fuck is he talking about? I introduce you.
I'm scared.
Wow. Who the fuck is we?
You're talking tough to me.
Hey, who the fuck is we? Gladys Knight in
I'm
the
scared.
Pips.
I'm
fuck
scared.
Is he talking about?
Ladies and gentlemen,
he introduced me.
I like to introduce
who the fuck is we?
Gillie,
Ren and
nut.
Stimpy.
But listen,
fuck is he
let me
talking
just say
about?
This. Let me say this,
nigga. I'm Gillie the King, and you Wallo the nut ass nigga.
But you know
the
what?
Legendary nut ass nigga.
You sound real tough.
The nut of all nut ass niggas.
I'm scared.
Fuck is you talking
wow.
about? I introduce you. Who
ooh,
the
I'm
fuck
scared.
Made them
yeah,
rules
shut
up.
Up? Listen, man. But
who made them goofy ass
back,
rules up?
We're back, and I what?
Fuck is you talking about?
Before
you little cuz, nigga.
All right, I got some for
you. You the one that was sitting back watching me slay the bitch. Talk about damn because I ain't know you got down like that, nigga.
You lying?
Fuck would you ever?
You
be
right.
Introducing me, Nick.
You right, you right.
Fuck is you talking
listen,
about? When we used to dance back in the day, you had the ankle sock, I had the tube sock. Fuck who you look like introducing me, nigga.
No, the ankle sock I had, that
fuck
was...
Fuck is I'm talking about? I'm Jordan, you
NBA,
pimping, nigga.
I had an NBA ankle
fuck
sock.
Fuck is you talking about? I'm Isaiah, you Joe Stewart,
was NBA,
nigga.
It was an NBA
fuck
ankle sock.
Fuck is you talking about?
13. It was NBA. It was,
fuck is he talking
about? Jordan Shaq in them wear. I had an NBA ankle sock.
First of all, so Shaq ain't wear ankle socks. Ain't no ankle socks in the fit Shaq feet. Fuck is you talking about?
I had an NBA ankle sock.
Size 21 ankle sock.
What
the fuck out of here?
Listen, this boy's a hater, but I will say this, Dev. This episode is brought to you by and sponsored by Boyd's Funeral Services. Listen, they're affordable. This is affordable service. I'm talking about serving all religious and ethnic background, everybody. It's serving everybody. And it's affordable. So, like, I know people that, so you better be, like, really digging yourself because when you go off, if you go out before me, you're done. I told you.
Let me just tell you something.
Listen, I'm putting rest in your cash. What's your name?
So you saying they'll box you up in style for something cheap?
They'll box you up in style. Their service is impeccable. It's memorable. It's just, it's comforting during that time when your family, you know, you're just going through so much.
Day service can't be comforting to the nigga that's in the box.
No, it's comfortable. If you think about this though. Think about this. You ever notice when somebody's in like in the box, they real comfortable and they chilling.
No, they not.
Nah.
They not there. Fuck is you talking about? That's just a cold ass body.
No, they comfortable though. Everybody always chilling. I ain't go to no funerals before and didn't see nobody chilling. But you, oh man, I'm telling you, you're done. You're done. Listen, if you go out before me, I'm throwing some resi on you.
And some Magnum Minis.
I'm having some Reggie. No, I'm having a case of Magnum Minis. There's a Reggie hanging out of his pocket. They're like, damn, Gil went out hard. He went out wild.
Listen, you got a lot of shit.
And it's going to be some seeds.
You got
it's going to be a bunch
of
seeds.
You got a lot of shit going in your motherfucking joint. A Milli Vanilli CD. A motherfucking a denim belt.
And a pack of Rangers. A party pack.
He having a box of Red Rangers.
I'm going to say this. First of all, my people at Boyd's. funeralservices.com. Boys Funeral Service.com. You get with them if you need good service. Philadelphia, Jersey area. Listen, you get with them if you need good service. They're outstanding. They're no joke. They're my people. So they're going to take care of me if I go. And plus, around my casket, we're going to have grandmasters watching me. So you're not going to be able to get to my casket. But if you're trying to get with Boys Funeral Services, get out, reach out to agent. Listen, she's going to take care of you. She's the funeral director. She's going to make everything happen.
She the one.
Yo,
The funeral director.
Yo, man, you got to get the grease off your lips or something.
What are you talking about grease on my lips? That sounds spicy.
No, because you be just spicy. Come on, my nigga.
She's a spicy. She's a funeral director. But listen, I will say this about Asia. You always can contact Asia at 856-963-1515. 856-963-1515. But I will say this.
And that's a serious.
But I was, we pat people down at my funeral.
Hold on, man. That's a serious shout out because on the real, a lot of people is getting murdered out here and a lot of people is dying every day and a lot of people can't afford good service. So she provides good service at a cheap rate. So make sure you holler at Boy's Funeral Home. And it's just like that.
It's just like that. But I will say this. You're not coming to my funeral. We patting people down. I'm telling you, I had grandmasters at my funeral. Because everybody's coming out around the country.
So let me just
All the dojos going to be doing security at my funeral.
So you're going to have... You're gonna have around your casket, you just gonna have a legendary number of nut ass niggas just circling your casket.
You got a real thing with disrespecting martial artists. But you wanna praise boxers.
You wanna praise boxers.
I praise the motherfuckers
who really do that.
He did step the boxers. You saw what happened when B-Rock, you know, what happened a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, he started bitching at a rapid rate. Nah, I saw it. You saw it too.
No, he didn't.
I gave him a way out.
He said he was talking about T.Y. Jennings.
I gave him a way out.
Exactly.
Martial artists just think. It's not about violence.
He didn't want to tune that nigga up.
Let's get the $1 million worth of game, man. Let me ask y'all a question. And you niggas better pick one. I don't want to hear no, don't be making up no excuses. None of that shit. In a relationship, which is more important? Your woman mom likes you or your mom likes your woman? See for me.
This dude, man, always with his nonsense.
See for me, it don't matter if my mom don't like Toot. I don't give a fuck.
I'm kind of on that time.
But if Toot mom don't like me, if the woman mom don't like you, then that causes a bunch of bullshit and a bunch of animosity and a bunch of problems within your relationship, especially if your woman is as close to her mom as Toot is to her mom. So for me, I would want, if I had to pick between one, I mean, I would want both of them.
Right.
But if I had to choose between one, I would want to be cool with Tootie mom.
But then your mom just coming at Toot every time she see her, stupid bitch.
But no, you know
my mom already do that.
Your mom, but listen, this is the old twist. Your mom, a lot of times when it comes to their son, they be iffy anyway.
Yeah.
So I'd rather my girl mom, because your mom is always gonna be iffy. They're gonna be on some always, this is my son. So and then it's like you taking my son away. It'd be a lot of stuff. Yeah. So I'd rather my woman mom.
That makes sense.
Bitch, you didn't say nothing.
Fuck, I did. You. I said I agree with you before he said it.
Oh, so we all in agreement that we'd rather it be our woman mom over our moms. Our own personal moms who pussy we dropped out of.
Yeah.
Let me just remind
you. I'm going to tell you what, remix it. No. I'm going to tell you why.
Try remix
because
it.
The end.
Yeah, that's what we said.
No, because the end all be all is that you want to be liked by both people. Cause your mom's still gonna fuck with you, and then her mom fuck with you. So you like, I don't give a fuck if they don't fuck. That's what happened.
You're like, both of them fuck with me.
That's on you. It must be something with you.
It must be something with you
that got my mom not fucking with you.
That's deep shit. I ain't even look at it like that.
Yeah,
you like everybody.
It's really
cool.
Selfish on our part.
Yeah, we like, we don't care.
Okay,
we
ain't so shit. if your woman cheat, and you catch her, are you a sucker?
Hold up, what you mean?
What you mean catch her? You catch her? What you gotta be a sucker? Cause you caught a cheat.
You just caught her.
And you stay with her.
Oh, you ain't say that part. You ain't say that.
Yeah, that's what I mean. I mean, y'all motherfuckers cut me off.
But hold up. Is it a cheat back?
Is
you catching a cheating? Is he cheating back on you for cheating?
It could be.
Hold on. I think it depends. Because if she never knew you was cheating, and then she cheated anyway, she cheated off of her own. It wasn't really revenge.
That was her own cheat.
But if she caught you cheating and it was revenge, then you might... I'm not saying I would charge it, but I can see how a nigga might charge it again. He might have fucked 8 bitches, and then he got to just charge it. Like,
he got to charge it. Would you charge it?
Nah.
You would have killed. He's going to kill dude.
So if April cheated on you, is you charging it to the game?
I'm not charging nothing to the game. I'm out.
Hell yeah.
I'm out.
Hell yeah.
You lying.
No, he not. No, he not.
He's fucking lying.
No, he not.
He's a nut ass nigga. He's not. First of all, April run a relationship. That's
I don't know why he keeps saying
that. How would she explain that to that nigga? Like, what would it be like, babe? You be leaving early in the morning, making the motivational videos, and I wake up 6 o'clock in the morning, and there's nobody there. You're not there. Listen, you're there.
You're not there.
You're there for the rest of America and all the kids in the streets, but you aren't there for me.
You need to motivate these bandits.
I'm motivated buns, though. Yeah, no, I'm motivated buns.
Ricky Blaze would be the one motivated.
Stop giving Ricky Blaze an advertisement on here.
Ricky might see you leaving out the crib 6 o'clock in the morning. He slide right.
Don't do that.
That's because he's still on jail time. He go to sleep at 8 and he wake up at 4 in the morning.
Yeah, so she can't fuck at night. She can't fuck on the late night. And then you all.
By the time she wake up, he gone. He hopping a fence.
Yeah.
Get up.
Yeah. He preaching to other niggas about what they should be doing with they bitch, talking about something. So sometimes you gotta make sure that you come with roses every day. I bring her roses every day, but you don't wake up with her, nigga. I'm tired of that shit too, cause you giving my girl ideas and shit. You popping up with roses and all this
he
shit.
He wanna be 4:30 in the morning. Young boys. Go get your lady roses, young boys. Ain't even no stores open. I pick these roses, youngins. You hear me? That's when you gotta make your woman heart break dance, youngin.
Oh,
if
God.
Your woman heart ain't new, you gotta make your woman fucking panties break dance, young boy. Fuck what he talk about. The heart, that shit grow old. Let me tell you something. When you get as many years as me and Tootie got in, fuck the heart. Yeah, me. We don't even really like each other no fucking more. We just content with being with each other because we've been together fucking long.
He's crazy.
And the bottom line is, like, Tootie can't even picture herself waking up next to another motherfucker after all these years. Me either. We don't even like each other half the fucking time. Y'all be thinking that shit a game. Oh, that is funny for Instagram. No, me and Tootie really be in the fucking crib going at it.
They be going at it. They be warring.
Like, we be fucking gang warring. They be messing in the crib.
You know what's crazy? Only thing I don't like about when I'm over their crib is like, they don't have no respect for nobody's privacy. I be over there asleep, like on the couch, and they be making all this goddamn noise. And I'm like, yo, like, what type of time is y'all on? Y'all got fucking company. I'm down here because I go, like, their couch. I really love their couch. I like to kick my sneaks off and just lay down there. They got, like, this blanket. Only reason I don't like that blanket that be on the joint, too, is, like, it's not a blanket. It's, like, this furry thing because it be straight and, like, sometimes be on my clothes. But at the same time, I'm like, yo, why is y'all making all this fucking noise?
Hold on, so do you spend the night on that couch sometimes?
Fuck no. But listen, so answer the question. Because
you know why he said no.
No, fuck no. Don't try to get away from it. So if you cheated on your woman and then she cheated back on you, is you staying with her?
First off, I want to make it very, very, very clear. I want to make it very clear to the citizens of this great nation that we're at that black men don't cheat.
Yes,
if it was a cheat back.
In an alternate universe, if it was a cheat back, I'm still out. Fuck that. You know what I'm saying? Like, no, I'm a man with pride. You don't do shit like that. I was just fucking them girls. I was getting right back. What are you talking about?
So what if she told you that? I was just sucking them niggas' dicks. I was going to get right back.
Listen, I don't even want to think about where my brain would go in that.
This is the thing about Deb.
So you saying if your woman cheat, because y'all got to understand.
Listen,
y'all got to understand that it is millions on top of millions on top of millions of guys every day who women cheat. And they take them back. They work through it. They get past it.
Kids. It be property. Okay. Yeah. All type of stuff.
But what niggas got to understand is when they cheat, when a woman cheat, like, you know how, like, Gil said he been in a relationship and they start getting, like, staler or whatever? When women cheat, that dude is a new nigga. They be showing off. When I was out here in the streets, the shit she doing with me, she not doing with him no more. That's what they used to do 15 years ago. She's showing up. She in the bed playing with her. So she mad. She on some other type.
Let me tell you one thing, Sue. When your woman cheat, the harsh reality of this is the nigga she cheated on you with, She sucked his dick better than yours.
Oh, yeah.
You know why?
She's trying to make a statement.
No. You know why? Because she sucked your dick 18,000 times.
There's nothing new
so
to it.
So now you get them lazy dick sucks. You get a little blood.
She corning the cob disjoints with the other boy. She on the side with it, corning the cob. No. The whole night.
Hey, listen. The other nigga.
Yeah.
I'm talking about she slapping us.
Yeah. Yo, I thought Gillie just broke his skull.
Hey, listen. Because it's get that serious. That's how she's slapping herself in the face with that dick.
Yeah.
I'm talking about she holding her tongue out. Oh, come on, right here. Yeah. All kinds of shit.
That's a fact. That's a super fact. And they be videotaping and all that. She be on that type
of time.
She getting pistol whipped.
And then listen. It's an introduction. So
a vicious introduction.
She gotta introduce herself right.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So she's sucking this dick like it's the last dick on planet Earth.
Yeah.
She trying to suck the leather off a jacket. Yeah, man. So you gotta understand the way she just dropped that pussy on him.
Yeah.
You ain't got that type of droppage in goddamn 10, 11 years.
Oh shit. Know what, yo? It's something I gotta admit to Gil, man.
What?
It's some shit, man. What's going on? We like to, me and Wallo, we like to go against Gil a lot of times when he's, you know, saying he's Dr. Phil and all of this type of shit. And because he never went to college or nothing, you know what I'm saying? But a couple weeks ago at the live show, you know, a gentleman raised his hand and said he needed some game. And he said that he didn't get his dick sucked.
Oh, yeah.
In 4 years from his girl.
4 years.
I mean, pandemonium hit the room. Women jumped up, 100 women, easy, jumped up. Booing this man's wife and everything. I know this man's wife. She was a little bit embarrassed. And Gil made them come on the stage. But to fast forward, I received a message, and now I have to admit to Gil, you are Dr. Gil. She said it was a
what?
One, he got his dick sucked.
Oh,
so
God
yeah,
damn! I know he blew. I know that was like a shotgun blast to the head. Yeah. She was in there like that. Motherfucker said, "Boom!"
Yeah,
her fucking brains out the roof.
She was just like, you know, when they got home, it opened up a lot of like big conversation in their relationship. You know, for him to do something that drastic, because that was drastic. You know what I mean? For him to go up there in front of that whole room full of people and let them know that he ain't had his pistol polished in that many years. You know
That's
what I'm saying?
That's a long time. Yeah,
like how you don't get your gun shined in 4 years?
And
like,
she said, man, just tell Gillie, you know, he saved our relationship.
That's
Gillie,
major.
She said
That's
Gillie
major,
saved
man.
Our relationship.
I'm talking about if he ain't get one of them. Grab the back of your fucking head, try to shove my dick through the back of your fucking skull. Dick sucks. I'm talking about where she choking, gagging, damn near borderline about to throw up on the dick. I'm talking about if he ain't get one of them nasty joints, spit everywhere, where you got to put a fucking towel down.
Your shit, anything wet.
You got to put a towel down, all this shit wet, everything is. If he ain't get one of them, she's still out of fucking pocket.
Now he walking around real happy right now. This dude,
Wait. Hold on. Wait. If you don't get your dick sucked for 4 years, a bitch breathe on your dick.
You'll be happy. I love it.
Just you feel the hot air on your dick. A bitch.
I love you, baby.
Easy. She was like, easy work.
Right.
You got queued up, man.
Like my goodness, 4 fucking years without a fucking tune-up?
Yeah. And he was a sheet nigga, too. So so he gave it all up to be in this relationship. So
No. He couldn't have been a true sheet nigga.
Nah, he was, man.
He couldn't have been.
I seen him
Let
in
me
action.
Tell you something. I don't give a
See,
fuck.
Oh, he's telling me you seen him in action.
Nigga, we used to be knocking Jones down.
So you seen him in action.
Yeah, we used to be out knocking Jones down. Nigga.
Action!
Hold on, wait.
Was you holding the camera or something?
Nah, nigga, I was knocking something down. You feel what I'm saying?
Wait. I seen him in action.
Wait, so y'all.
That sounds like the shit Gillis say when we was doing our thing back in the day.
So
he say about me. So, I seen Wild in action.
No,
I wasn't looking up to him. No, I wasn't. He watched me in action.
Wait, hold on. So, when you say you seen him in action,
I'm saying
what? Explained?
What I'm explaining is we would be knocking down Jones. I would have a joint. He would have a joint. But we'd be in the same room. You know, back in the day, niggas was broke. We ain't buy separate hotel rooms because we was broke ass niggas that worked at like office.
Let me just tell you something. Back in the day, Wallo never had no bitches. I always had to pass him off bitches like a baton at the like man. A baton.
Let him say this.
See, listen, I have my own bitches, but I used to get short stays. You ever go to the motels and you get short stay for like $40?
An hour.
Yeah, absolutely. I used to do that.
Wallo don't know nothing about that. He never stopped at a hotel for 2 hours.
It's your lie. Bitches. Go ahead, tell it.
He never believes a bit. See, back then, Wallo was young though, so he had a little personal bitches, but he never had no bitches that party.
It's your lie. Go ahead, tell it.
You never brought no bitches that party.
It's your lie. Go ahead, tell it.
You brought some party to material.
It's your lie. Go ahead, tell it.
I'm asking you. In our whole life, you brought some party material to the table for
Big. Now, we talking about when I was Philadelphia Slim. When I was Philadelphia Slim.
Okay.
Did you or did you not?
Did you or did you not bring some smut to the table for me? I always brought the smut to the table.
He used to call me the party promoter because I stayed bringing him to the party.
No, he did.
Wallo's a promoter. He stayed.
More PP in the building.
Philadelphia Slim.
Fuck out of here. Wallo was a hell of a wide receiver. He'd catch your bitch and then listen.
Trying to run off with
it. No, listen. This the whole thing that used to fuck me up as a youngin'. I'll bring a bitch to the table. You know? I'll put her in the play for us.
He ready to lie on me.
But then.
Ready to lie on me.
This nigga would like say shit that ain't supposed to be said during the party. You know, when you party in the bitch, damn, how that thing is, cuz, yeah, this thing good, cuz, yeah, how, you know, suck this dick, yeah, hey, cuz, hold on, pass me the baby oil. You know, you say all kinds of, not with Wallo.
He sounded like LL Cool J.
Wallo look a bitch in the eyes. Your mind's forever. You're like, yo, what the fuck are you talking about, dog?
I'll be waiting.
No, I never said that. I love you. I'm going to kick Dev. Dev, can
dog,
I say
this? This nigga was 15, right?
Can I give you the real game?
This nigga was 15.
He's lying to me. I didn't say that.
Listen,
I never
this
said
nigga
that.
Was 15, right? This was back in the day. This nigga was 15.
He lying on me.
I was 18. The girl was 18. This nigga said, he hitting it. He looking her in the eyes. He talking about, you with me now forever. You going to let me be your pimp? She like.
He lied.
She 18 looking at a 15-year-old type of, you going to let me be your pimp? She
He lied.
Yeah. You come back tomorrow, ain't you? She looking like.
Nah, probably
if,
not.
If your cousin wants you to come back tomorrow. Like,
I'm his lying,
bitch.
Man.
Like, she like, I'm his bitch.
He's
I'm
lying on me, man.
Yeah.
All right, let me explain.
Your narration just wasn't.
You're not
there
even
yet.
Supposed to be getting none of this pussy. You 15.
Can I say something though? Can I be straight up with? I never said nothing like that.
You never said. So you gonna say a lot, cuz, never said. You never asked the bitch during a party. Come on, cuz. Now we gonna keep it 100.
He's lying on me, man.
Okay, so cuz, put this on Jackie. You on your mama.
She ain't got nothing to do with
No.
They ain't got nothing to do with this.
Okay. Put this on Steve. Put this on Steve that back in the day, we ain't party a chick and you was doing, first of all, it's supposed to be one in the mouth, one from the back. One in the rack, one from the back, right?
Yeah.
This nigga say, cuz, can you give me like 10 minutes?
He kissing her.
No, I wasn't. No.
Yo,
no,
you wasn't, was no. Missionary style.
So now I just got to go chill. Why? He want to lay down missionary style.
I knew it.
Listen, he want to put his arms over the bitch joints, lock her shoulders in like a motherfucking, like a roller coaster.
Yeah.
And then lay face to face and ask dumb ass questions.
Yeah, talk in her ear.
I'm your pimp, ain't I?
He lied.
He was like, let me whisper something in your ear.
He
said shit like,
he lied to me.
This study, you gonna be with me forever, ain't you?
He lied to me.
She like, nigga, you 15.
No,
like,
I'm gonna tell you like, exactly.
You ain't supposed to be getting none of this pussy. Damn.
You like this freshman dick, don't you?
You like this?
I'm not gonna lie.
You like this freshman?
I'm gonna tell you what I told him.
See a cold senior here. You like this freshman dick?
Listen, I got my 8th grade diploma.
I'm gonna tell you exactly what I told him, man. I'm gonna tell you. I didn't say things like that. He's too far fetched. I wasn't that crazy. I would say things to the matter of, I've been waiting for this for a long time. Where have you been? I'm glad I'm found.
Well, why would you be asking like, where was a whore at?
I don't know.
I've been waiting for a whore like you.
Right. That's the type of
it felt like a special moment. It's like
I was waiting for
cuz. I
was waiting for
cuz
to pass you off my whole life.
I'm just be 100% honest. And we're going to know by looking dead in your eyes. The camera is right on you, bro. When that nigga walked out the room, Did you kiss the bitch?
No.
He kissed her.
No.
He definitely kissed her because Wallo would kiss her.
I never did that.
Wallo would kiss her.
I did not kiss her.
Yes, he did.
No. Yo.
And he sucked trick titties.
No, he lied.
Yes, you did.
He lied on me.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. One bitch, you suck the shit out of titties. I'm getting head. He trying to suck the titties. I'm like, yo, get the fuck away from
me. He lying on me, Dev. Dev, he's lying on me, Dev.
Dev,
he's lying on me. Dev, wait.
Let me tell you, Dev.
We're doing the geometry. No, we doing the wait. Let's do the measurements on this. Let's do the science.
Can you listen?
He's lying on me.
How can he get sucked off?
Dev, can you listen? Can you listen? All right. The bitch was, she's sitting on her knees, right? On the floor. When she come up, she right at dick level, right?
Come on,
so
man.
So listen.
You're lying on me.
Listen. So, I'm standing up. She gunning me. Next thing I know.
He's under your balls.
Yes. This nigga's crawling. Dog.
Yo.
Listen. Next thing I know.
His boy's a liar.
Next thing I know.
He's a habitual liar. He's lying on me, Dev.
Listen.
Dev, he's lying on me.
Hold on. Wallo was 15 years old.
He's lying on me.
Next thing I know, I feel the nigga, first of all, you're not supposed to, ain't no touching.
Your knee is hitting his spine.
I don't know about the knee hitting his spine.
To the viewers out there, I would like to have a disclaimer this man is lying on me.
Listen.
He's defamation of character.
Listen. You know when you naked, you got a broad in the room, nothing don't touch. Legs, nothing.
He's lying on me.
Let me get in there, cuz. He grazed up against my leg, leaned over, started sucking the titty. I said, dog, what the fuck is you doing, cuz?
Yeah, the titty is only so far from the mouth.
This nigga was like this far away from my nuts.
If he wasn't a little cuz,
I'd have treated him in that joint.
Yo, he lying, man.
Because I snapped out on him.
He lying.
I'm like, cuz, you only a foot away from the nuts, cuz. Like,
yo, word up. He's lying on me, Dad.
Hey, you had nut sweat on you, bro.
Listen.
No.
Listen.
No.
Listen.
No.
And listen. No. And it was the top of his fucking head. He like this. Let me get in there, cuz. Like, who wants to suck a titty during a party? Like, I'm standing up. Nah. I'm talking crazy. I'll get that.
He's lying on me.
No. You got, that's from you watching pornos, bro.
Yeah.
You was watching pornos and you was trying to live out everything you ever saw in that moment. Because that's how it is. Because when you, not for real, because when you in a threesome, sometimes you ever been in a threesome and you just try and you keep switching positions like every two, like every like 30 seconds because you just want to do everything. Like, oh, then I saw this.
That's you, Dev. That's not me. That's you.
You know what I'm saying? They like, this nigga can't make up his motherfucking mind. Like, what the fuck is this nigga
trying
to do?
That's not me. That's Dev.
But listen, he was young, and once I chastised him, I put him through the ringer. I told him the rules of the game. He ain't never fuck up again. Look at him. Look at his face. He looks sad as shit. I'm exposing him today, don't he?
He's lying.
Look at his face.
He's an habitual liar.
Let me tell you something. You know when you know a motherfucker telling the truth with Wallo? When all he say is, he lying.
Mm-hmm. He lying on me all the time.
He lying.
I don't know where he get this stuff from, man.
Come on,
I really don't know
where I get that shit from. Who would you be?
Oh, man. This section of Who Would You Be is sponsored by, have you had any good hair lately? Everything, divaglam.com. Check them out if you're looking for that stellar, that beautiful, that soul glow. Check them out. Everything, divaglam.com.
Who would you be?
Who would you be?
About who? Who's the who would you be, nigga?
He's asking. Who would you be?
He didn't answer. He ain't asked the people.
Would you be R. Kelly?
No. No.
So we know the answer.
I'm never going to be R.
Jesse Smollett?
No.
John Wayne Bobby.
Oh, whoa. Jay, listen. JWB? That's crazy. About 25. I was just watching something on JWB.
So for all the young people who don't know.
25 John, years ago.
Yeah.
Listen. Lorena Bobby was his wife. She disconnected his manhood. She cut his penis off and threw it down the street.
Yeah.
They went and found it and they sold it back to him. Now, when they sold it back to him, he wound up getting a deal. He wound up doing a porno.
Yeah,
he did a porno. They paid him money to be in the porno and all that. But could you imagine, though,
your dick being just in the tall
she
grass?
Cut his piece off.
But, bro, your dick down is just in the grass.
Threw it down the street and they found it and they sold it back on him.
I don't know if I could be him because I don't know if I could be out here with a reconstructed gun.
Yeah, his shit look like Frankenstein with like bolts and fucking stitches.
But how do you put your piece back on? Like, that's crazy.
Right, like how you Like, if you slice a hot dog in half, how you put that fucking joint back together? Like,
but Dev, out of these three, out of like, Jesse Smollett.
And then, hold on. And then, okay, so if this is your dick, and you cut
veins and
this much of the dick off through the veins and everything, you throw this dick down the street, right? Okay, just this little stub on, that's the only shit that got life to it. That part, this part of the dick that's in the street, that's now dead.
Yeah. It's so dead in the grass.
It's dead. Like, that dick don't have no heartbeat going through it.
They can't resuscitate
no
that part?
How?
Put it on a machine?
That's what I want to know. How do you, when you sew the dick back on, dude, how does the feeling come back to the dead
well,
part of the dick?
He was in a porno.
You know what? Who would you be?
Yeah, who would you be, Gil?
I know who I'd be.
You'd be the gay Tupac.
Who? Nah. You don't know.
He did.
Jesse Smollett said he was going to be.
Yeah,
he
Jesse
was the
Smollett
gay
was gay Pac.
Wow.
Gay he Pac. Said he was a gay Tupac.
He claimed he was gay Pac. Nobody's
so who would
going
you
for
be?
That. I'm not going to be R. Kellz because I'm not fucking kids. I'm not going to.
He going to be Jesse.
See, hold on. The boy Jesse.
He's just going to be Jesse Smollett.
No, the boy.
You're
going to
be Pac.
Nah, the boy. I'm not going to be Pac. Guess what, bro? I'm going to be Bobbitt, man.
You gonna be JWB?
I'm gonna tell you why.
Yeah. John Wayne Bobby?
I'm gonna tell you why. Think about this. KD just got hurt, right? Tore his Achilles, whatever happened.
We talking about cutting your piece off,
yeah,
man.
But listen, he a professional in the sport. People waiting for him to come back. They want to see him get better. This man is a legend. He came back from adversity. For a nigga to go from his piece laying in the motherfucking ShopRite parking lot to him doing a porno back in action, that's a story. That's
right.
A
porno.
That's
all his whole thing is based off the porno.
Yeah,
that's all Dev worried about getting in the porno.
Fuck,
this is a story.
You just want to get in the porno.
This is a story of just
okay,
like
let me,
triumph.
Okay, let me tell
you just
something.
Worrying about BJs.
Let me tell you something, Dev. Imagine that
your
fucking piece? Feeling of your piece
no,
getting cut off.
It's a nightmare.
And you look down, you see stub and nuts.
But imagine how much he appreciates his piece now that is all back and working. They might have put something cybernetic. Like, his shit might be bionic. His shit might be on some
other
shit.
I don't want no bionic piece. I just want my piece.
Yeah, that's crazy.
So, who would you be?
No, who would you be?
Who you going to be? You going to stick your piece in little kids or stick your piece in men? Because that's what the other choices are. J. Gill.
Freaky Gill. Golden Shower.
Damn, man, I might gotta get my piece kicked off the bed. Huh? I might gotta kick my piece off the bed, man.
See?
Damn.
Now, I'm smarter than I look.
Now I'm gonna say this. R. Kelly Jones messed up. If he had any other case, I wouldn't mind because I do the time. I was a time machine at one time, but I got to get my piece detached, man.
See,
I got to be the boy. The chicks be telling me, you know, he got his piece cut off. He got to reconstruct your piece.
Well, you know. I could really see you being more on the Jesse Smollett.
That's what I think.
Whoa.
I honestly think
you just going to throw me out of the bus like
Wallo
that.
Smollett?
I can see that.
I feel like Wallo Smollett fits you.
I ain't smelling nothing. I don't want to smell shit.
No, because you know what the niggas used to tell you in jail?
Well, they ain't tell me nothing.
Take lock up, a nigga get popped up.
Listen, you lying.
Both of y'all allegedly claimed to have been like fighting people in alleyways, and some people don't believe you.
I really was fighting people. Hold up.
I'm
really a martial artist.
I'm just saying that you have been charged
take
with.
Take lock up, a nigga get popped up. Who you going to be?
Listen, man, I'm going to be JWB.
So we all going to be JWB?
Yeah.
Y'all biting off me. I pick first.
JWB's a legend.
We all gonna be JWB.
He came back.
He came back with a tarnished piece.
We gonna be the Frankenstein.
Fucking rusty 38. Fuck is you talking about? Let's get to $1 million worth of game.
$1 million worth of game.
So this girl says, "Hey Gilly, I have a question. So I was dealing with a D-list celebrity for a little bit." Damn.
She mad at him. That's all that was. D-list. He's probably more.
I never heard of D-list.
He's probably at least B. Yeah. Go ahead. I don't know
who
it is.
She said, "I was dealing with a D-list celeb for a little bit, but things came to a head when I wasn't into the same things he was into sexually. He wanted me to sleep with other men in front of him, but I wasn't down with it. He got mad and threatened to cut me off." So I cursed him out. And that was that. He blocked me on IG for a month. And now recently I've noticed that I'm unblocked. Should I take it as a sign that he's willing to make peace, or should I let it be? Let me tell you something.
Yo, she said D-list, first of all. Then she said he want her to get body slammed by other dudes in front of him.
But hold on, but because first, you know so why? We figure it out who's
because
D.
Shorty, I hate to be the one to tell you.
He's spicy.
But no, you're a smutty butty.
He was basically trying to.
You're a.
Set up the. Set
a
up
pop
the party.
And drop.
Yeah.
You're a smash and dash. A poke and stroke, damn. Whatever you want to name it, you hear me? Because he has, let me just tell you something. He enjoys your company. You're not for, you're for tonight. That's it. You're not for every night. And he wants to share you. He wants to pass you off like a fucking baton in the 4x4 relay at the Penn Relays.
Everybody, please me, could you inform people about the Penn Relays? Everybody not familiar with it.
Okay, the Penn Relays is
the Olympics, basically.
A track event that goes down here in Philadelphia.
But if you say the Olympics, more people understand. Like,
okay, well, that's what he wants to do. So if he gets mad that you don't want to fuck his homies and he cuts you off, then you're nothing more to him than a whore.
Yeah. He don't got no respect for
him? None. In his mind, you're from Orlando, Florida.
Checklist slut vodka.
Yeah.
But she said he's a D-list. Yo, who's considered the whore?
Bitch from Atlanta, Georgia.
Not to throw anybody under the bus.
Horsetown, New Jersey.
Horsetown, New Jersey. Yeah. Oh, okay.
Not Morristown, Horsetown.
Hawaii. Fuck it.
Listen, not meaning to throw anybody under the bus, but I know Gil had no problem doing that. Who would you say out here is a D-list actor?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, you don't have no respect for yourself because D-list is at the bottom of the barrel. That's like me. Like, I'm D-list. Like, no, I'm at the bottom.
A D-list actor?
Yeah, who's a D? No, she said a D-list celebrity, right?
A D-list.
Like, I never heard of that.
Well, who would be considered a D-list without throwing nobody under the bus? But I know you will.
Dog, no D-list. One.
Don't kill nobody like that.
No one.
A D-list.
Oh, wow. I was about to say.
He's ready to get somebody.
I was ready to say a D-list celebrity, but I ain't.
Don't do it. Don't do it.
Go ahead.
Don't do it.
Go ahead. Do it.
Nah. I ain't going to do it.
Man. I thought this is where we live our truths and everybody not scared. I thought this nigga was a thug.
I mean, but Wallo acting like another ass nigga.
I thought you was a gangster.
Oh, I'm not a gangster at
no,
all.
No, I'm talking to him.
Oh, no, he's not a gangster either.
Don't bring up my past, Dev.
leave that over. That life is over.
So, to the lady, if the shoe fit, wear it, baby. You know what I mean? If you're going to be a whore, be the best whore you could be. If you're not going to be a whore, then clean your fucking act up. What you talk about? You ain't into what he into. Why would he think you into that type of shit if that's not what you into? So something that you did show him that you got whorish ways.
Hold the fuck up.
Because nobody would try that on a random person. Like, nobody tries that unless they know, like, she's definitely a whore.
Hold up. One thing. If I'm not fucking mistaken, it's funny, not to jump off the subject, but I jump off the subject because that's what I want to do. When I was in jail and I talked to you on the phone one time, you told me you was at R. Kelly fucking house.
Oh, yeah, I was.
What the fuck was you doing at R. Kelly house?
Wait. So we was just talking about R. Kelly and he tried to be slick.
Yeah, you was at R. Kelly fucking house.
That's your boy?
I mean, I know.
When you was at his house, did you see him piss on somebody?
Come on, man.
I'm just asking. You told me you was at his house.
Hold on, you was at his house.
You told me you was at his house, Gil.
Okay.
When I was in jail.
Hold on, wait.
You said, I was doing R.
What type of question is that? When you was at R. Kelly, did you see him piss on somebody?
I'm just asking.
Why would I be looking at R. Kelly's dick?
His house was a wild whorehouse.
Was his house a whorehouse? Like,
what happened in there?
I'm gonna take that back. Fuck, you think I'm trapped in the closet, nigga?
Forget all that.
Hello, Mr. Biggs. How you doing?
Forget all that.
Mr. Gill.
Is R. Kelly one of your friends? You was at his house, Gil.
Okay, let me say it like this.
Yeah, you was at his house.
Shut the fuck up. Like, yes.
That's like hold, I can say. Hold. R. Kelly's your friend right now?
Listen.
Has that been your homie? How long have you all been homies?
Okay, listen. When I can say I've met R. Kelly, I've been to his house, a few times.
Now you met him. Now you met him. You've been to his house a few times.
So now we're going to find out the hotel was really his song first or some shit like that.
See, no. What happened is I was signed to Cash Money. Baby and R. Kelly was doing the best of both worlds because Jay-Z at some point had backed up out of it when the allegations or whatever came out with R. Kelly with the girls, right? Okay, cool. So now when Baby and R. Kelly is doing the best of both worlds now. So we was with R. Kelly all the time. And what I could say about him is when I was around, he treated me good. So I ain't got nothing bad to say about him. He going through whatever he going through. That's on him. He got to deal with that with God.
Jay-Z the baby is a tremendous drop.
It is. It is. But listen, though. But one thing I can say is this nigga had a legendary fucking party at his house.
What happened?
He set us up good, too. Right. We get there. When we get there, he had a piece of paper taped on the front of his doors. Said, no cell phones on past this point. So niggas is out front like, damn, you can't even have your phone on at our crib. What type of shit?
Oh, man.
The fuck is
going on? What happened in there, man?
So we get in there. We go in. You know, he got this big-ass TV, the biggest TV I've ever seen in my life. This shit had to be 20 feet by 20 feet built in the motherfucking wall. He got a DJ right here. All the food is out.
See, he had your hype. That was nothing but a projection screen.
Hold on. Listen, no fucking projection screen. Fuck is you talking about, nigga? Listen, so now we chilling in this area for about 2 hours. All niggas. Him and Stunner walk off. They come back about 5 minutes later. Baby say, Gillie, come here, Gillie. So I walk over there, right? He say, he got 50 bitches back there in the pool area. So I'm like, what? He say, walk back here with me. We walk back there. Now, if you ever been to R. Kelly's house, his pool area is set up like the fucking Bahamas. Got palm trees, all kinds of shit in his joint. We open the door. These was the nakedest, friendliest bitches you would ever see in your life.
Naked bitches that just want a spelling bee, probably.
They was, no, these bitches was grown. Nigga, yeah. Fuck is you talking
about? Is you sure, Gil?
Yeah.
I'm just saying, because I don't want you to come. I don't want them.
I mean, at the end of the day, nothing didn't happen. So it didn't matter if the bitches was. It didn't. Wait, hold on, wait. You think this nigga's on trial for fucking with some kids, and we going to this nigga's crib after he just filmed himself all around the crib? We going to this nigga crib and doing anything with some bitches? Like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Why was you there, though, man?
But because we was there filming. He had a party. They did the best of both worlds, too. They did a party. He had a party. I'm going to do a party. We're going to do a get-together, man. Cash Money come through. So, you know, but...
Did anybody get pissed on at this event?
I didn't witness none of that, dog. Why you keep asking me about niggas' dicks?
Hold on, wait. You asking so crazy. Now,
keep nigga asking me about niggas' dicks. Did anybody pull a dick out and piss off?
Can I ask you this?
Type time is you on?
Without you going too far, was there anything that you saw that was just different or strange?
Was it strange?
Like
anything strange?
Like anything about, or he never said nothing crazy? Nothing?
I mean.
Nothing?
Okay. Like, when you at R. Kelly crib, and you know that the nigga's wife is upstairs in the bedroom. And supposedly this nigga bedroom locks from the outside. So it was like, get what you gonna get for the night and get the fuck up in there.
Oh, did you see that?
He's basically all right. CEO. He's CEO.
Okay, hold on. So, come on. So this is like two. All right, come on. What the fuck is you doing? Hey, you better. You know you be thirsty. You better take an extra fucking soda up there.
You know what's all crazy right about this? While right I'm laughing, I actually seen him lock two in the house before.
Right.
Him. I don't know if it was like if he was playing, or, but I seen it happen.
Yeah, I'm saying two. All right, come on. This like if I treated two like this, like all right, get number. All right.
He got a car with childproof right, cool locks in his room. All right, cool. And two that crazy to put in the car. You gonna sleep outside the car tonight?
Wow.
Yeah. He's vicious.
Don't fucking like, believe this thing.
He's vicious.
Listen, right. And then I locked the door from the outside. Bam. So if there's a fire, anything in this motherfucker, you're going to be a motherfucking hot wing in that motherfucker because you can't
you
get the
tell
fuck
me
out.
That's crazy.
All right? But I'm about to go downstairs for the rest of the night with these 50 bitches and we just going to enjoy
and
life.
She in there living niggas out stories from the cell.
Stories from Kellz. Stories from Kellz. From Kellz.
Wow.
So, you know, and then you be fucked up because I'm sitting in the living room and then a bitch come from the pool area, haul assing.
What?
Titties bouncing and everything.
Who was they running from?
She running from R, right? So,
So listen.
A bitch come from the pool.
No, she running from R.
Listen.
And you stay, you ain't leave.
Listen. A bitch running. She run from the pool area past the living room. I'm sitting on the couch. She all ass past me. Titties bouncing and everything.
R, come
right? Listen. He right behind her. So now she in the back of me on the couch. He in front of me. This nigga got a snork, goggles on. She in back of me. She like, stop it, Robert. Stop it. She run this way. He run this way. He run this way.
Right there.
I'm like this.
Is you kidding me?
It'd be a fucked up element to it because it's like, yo, we at R. Kelly house and this nigga's crazy. This nigga,
you ain't leave.
Like, why would I leave?
Yeah, what I get the, it.
Because I'm just saying, you can
hold on, but
this naked bitch just running by with their titties out.
So was he? So he wasn't.
You would have hauled ass out of there, huh?
I would have been there.
Hold on. Let me just tell you something. We got to check my. I got to check my cousin's resume because you say bitches running around with naked titties out. He talking about you didn't leave. What was you still there for?
The way he said
he want to keep knowing.
He said always chasing.
But listen,
he said, listen.
What he want to keep asking is. You ain't seen nobody pull his dick out and piss on somebody. What the lying. Fuck are you talking about?
The way he's saying it is out
how
of
you
pocket.
Gonna say I'm lying and people sit here watching this show?
I'm saying like the way he's trying to say it. Okay, but at the end of the day, he said R was chasing her.
We thought he was trying to beat her up. You didn't watch the special?
Yeah, that's what he said. He's chasing. I'm like, why the fuck are you?
Hold on. Was he a personal Paulie or he let everybody rock?
No. Okay, see one thing about R, when we first got down there, he set the present right from the gate. He said, listen, man, y'all can treat my studio like y'all studio. Do whatever the fuck y'all want. Just please, man, when you see my little bitches walking through the leave joint, just leave them alone.
What?
Like,
hold on. So he was the ultimate personal Paulie?
All the pieces
like,
was his.
Bitches that was at the studio that was ducked off, they was his. They wasn't.
How many was it?
I don't know. Just from time to time, you'll just see a bitch walk past or something. So there was art, but I'm.
He said, "Leave him alone."
Oh, I'm gonna keep it all the way real though. R. Kelly broke baby heart one fucking day.
What happened?
Okay, so baby had a girl. I fuck with the girl, so I ain't gonna put the name out there. That was from Chicago. That used to be with us, right? She was signed to Cash Money.
Why you told? You already told her.
Yeah, you're perfect. Go.
All right, so. He was trying. He was kind of taking a personal. You feel what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Kissing her in the mouth, all that old kind of personal. We get the R. Kelly shit. Shorty was from Chicago, though. We get the R. Kelly shit. We all in the room. He say, R. Kelly say, yeah, you know such and such used to roll with me, right? So
I'm trying to find
it. He don't know that this, like, baby girl. He think this just. A jump off.
Got it.
So he talking like a nigga will be talking to like if I know you got this man, yeah, you got that bitch, yeah, bitch, yeah.
Right here?
Yeah. So.
Yes.
So listen, right? So.
The first thing.
R say, yeah. You know. You
see the first one.
He say, you know she used to roll with me,
yeah,
right?
I used to like her when I was in jail.
Listen,
too.
Nigga, fuck all that.
I was in love with her, too.
Like, he like, you know she used to roll with me, right? Yeah, he like, I just asked her not to do one thing, and you know she couldn't do it. So baby was like, what was that, whoa? R was like, I asked her not to fuck the band. You know she had to fuck the band?
Damn. Are you kidding me?
Damn. The thing is, he was probably hitting it when she was like 15.
Whoa. Imagine a nigga telling that about your woman. Yeah, you know your woman used to fuck. She used to roll with me, man. Man, yeah, she was straight, man. I used to fuck with a man, but I just asked her not to do one thing, man. You know she couldn't do it. A nigga's telling you this about your woman. And you like, what? Man, I asked her not to fuck the band, man. You know she wasn't fuck the band.
You should have never asked what.
So she fucked public announcement.
Yeah.
Yo, I'm done.
Yo, and I was listening. That was one of my...
I'm the done.
I'm looking at her now. Listen, I'm looking at her now like... She was like... I used to see her... And,
damn.
You beat off to her in the jail, in the joint, huh?
Yeah. Did he? Bitch, fuck the band.
Yo, is you kidding me? She was everything.
Hey, that was a... I saw a stunner. Stunner took one of them joints like...
Yeah, it happens. It's a wild world out here.
Yo, she was just, she was nice. You remember her, right?
Yeah. It's a wild world out here.
She was nice. What was crazy, everybody that was in that joint was like, whoa, whoa. Because everybody that was signed to Cash Money knew this was like his shorty. Like, so niggas was in that joint like.
So what happened after? He cut off?
Fuck no, she was still a
I think Kellz knew he was throwing salt on the low. Yeah. Kellz knew, and Kellz, that was his way of just doing that shit. And played
I'm bigger than you.
Yeah. I'm had Kellz. It first. He tried to pull the Ray J Kim K joint.
Stories from the
I hit Kellz. It first.
Yeah, I hit it first. Yeah.
Meanwhile, his wife locked first up with all, the fucking
but,
Lunchables.
But hold on, but first of all, let's be for real.
Crazy,
let's
bro.
Be the fuck
that's
for real.
Crazy, man.
Ray J didn't hit it first.
Oh, he talking about he just mean out of them too. He don't mean in general. He don't mean. He didn't say I took her virginity.
Like, let's be for real.
He was being petty. He was being petty.
Gil, homie, friend. I'm not saying I ain't gonna put smut on Gil name, but R. Kelly, like he was at R. Kelly house.
Best of both worlds, two or three, almost was Gil in him.
Right? If Gil would have been on tape, he'd have been done.
You wouldn't have made Best of Both Worlds with him at that time if they said, nah, Stunner. It's just going to be you and Kellz. Come on, you would have made that album.
Kellz
and
Gillie.
Dog, listen, he was Kellz, making listen, the best listen, music listen, of his life hey, at listen, that time, hey, dog. Listen, you would have did it.
Dead. First of all.
Kellz and Gillie. Kellz and Gillie.
Best of Both Worlds.
Kellz and Gillie.
Hey, first of all.
Gil Kelly.
First of all.
That would have been a hot album. I don't give a fuck what nobody said.
G. Kelly.
First of all, he got one of my favorite songs of all time, though.
Which one?
It mean a lot to me.
Step in the Name of Love?
Mm-mm.
That joint a classic.
Listen, could you still listen
to R. Get a little toot-toot?
Oh, yeah, that joint.
Get a little beat.
I stopped fucking with him.
Could a person listen to R. Kelly music knowing all these allegations?
I literally had to cut him off, and it's a loss because this nigga music is incredible.
I don't. I don't really listen to it like that.
I really don't.
How the fuck you never listen to R. Kelly?
I'm talking about like, I never.
The fuck are you talking about?
I'm not no real live. I wasn't the type of boy, like, if I had to have some music and he got to be on the list. No, he ain't got to be on my play. I listen to different stuff.
Oh, no, I thought you were saying but you he had didn't stuff used
like,
to listen
like
to
Half
him.
On a Baby.
But you used to listen to him.
I Believe I Can Fly.
No. What the fuck are you talking about?
That's not in my,
like,
he's
before,
not on my phone.
Like, let's keep it real. Before R. Kelly allegations and all that, R. Kelly's in everybody's fucking
No, I'm just,
what the
listen
fuck
to
are
what
you
I'm
talking
saying.
About?
It was a couple songs
that's
that
like
I
a motherfucker saying, I don't listen to Michael Jackson. What the fuck are
his,
you talking
yo, his
about?
Resume, whoa, whoa, his resume is crazy. His resume is crazy.
Don't you ever say Mike name like that. Because you mean nobody never going to say they don't listen to Mike Jackson.
Don't
do that.
Who the
don't
fuck that? Say they never listen to R. Kelly?
I'm not saying nobody
the
said they never listen to
him. The fuck are you talking about?
I didn't say I didn't never listen. I said he's not in my playlist.
The fuck is you talking about? R. Kelly, the same nigga who make Can I Get a Little Toot Toot?
No, that's
can
his song. That's
bee,
your song.
Bee.
That's
no,
your favorite song.
That was everybody's song.
Now, I Believe You're Fine.
The fuck is you talking about? He make universal music that play forever. The fuck is you talking about?
I understand that. I understand that. But I'm saying though.
Don't we ain't gonna downplay the nigga talent and listen. The nigga can't read or write.
No, he's a legend, but don't
fuck
put his,
is you talking
don't
about?
Put his name with Mike
nigga,
though. I'm just saying. All
let
I'm
me tell you something.
His nigga. Name belong right with Mike. Mike on the sit. Listen, man. Let's
Mike
get
fuck
to the,
with them kids
yo,
too.
You know Mike fucked because Mike got a type. He fucked with all little white boys with the same type look.
Whoa!
It is what it is, bro.
Hold the
we
fuck
gotta
up.
Come
hold,
to.
Hold the fuck. Hold.
Let me tell you something.
Hold.
I had the glove.
Okay, let me tell you something.
Not disrespectful.
Okay,
I had the jacket.
Okay, let me just tell you something.
Don't do that shit. Don't do that to Mike. Don't do that shit.
Let me just tell you
something.
If allegations keep coming up that you're a thief, what's the fucking chances of you being a fucking thief?
It's allegations. It's not true.
I'm just asking.
I'm just saying.
What's the fucking chances?
Mike, who you're putting y'all.
What's the fucking chances of you being a thief if allegations keep coming up that you're a fucking thief?
Stop this. Stop
this
right now.
Yo, the nigga's a 10 on the weirdo meter.
Hold on. Now, I'm not saying Mike did anything wrong because he didn't get convicted of anything.
So you know
but what I'm just saying is sleeping in a motherfucking bed with kids that ain't your fucking kids and you a fucking
shot.
Adult. The fuck type of shit is that?
I think them false. But listen, I will say this.
Fuck, is you talking about?
You know what?
First
you know
of all,
what?
Let me just
you know
tell
what?
You something.
I'm going to say this
if I got your fucking kids at my house and they fucking seven. They ain't sleeping in the fucking bed with me and Tootie. The fuck are you? And that's my fucking family.
Listen, but see, I would say this.
So you think I'm gonna let some little Caucasian little kids come in? Oh, getting this. We all gonna sleep in the fucking bed together?
Yeah.
Fuck is you talking about?
Imagine you were sitting there like, I was in jail. I didn't get my childhood finished. So I sleep with little boys.
No, no,
they all sleep in the bed with kids.
That's not gonna happen. I will say this, though. Stop fucking slandering Mike's name. You know why? You know why? Everybody that's great that I know, everybody that's great that I give props to, that I celebrate because they was a legend and they have a true impact of a legend, he hate on them. You know why? Because you's a fuck. I know that girl was talking about, you're a D-list celebrity. Michael Jackson's a legend. He hate on Michael Jackson. He hate on Karate Earl. He hate on everybody that was somebody. All he do is hate on people.
Hate on Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson is the greatest of all time.
You just hated on him.
No, I didn't.
We talking about his practice.
You just try to slander him.
I'm talking about, okay, it was numerous cases where he admitted he sleeps in the bed with other people's
children. I never seen it.
All right, then forget it.
I never seen that.
Because you just want
to
be blind.
I think the lawyer told him to say that. The lawyer did that. No, Mike ain't do that shit. Right,
now
I'm going to just say this. I'm going to say this, though.
Now he want to play the motherfucking representation. Come on, man. Let's get into stories from the cell.
Stories from the cell. See, the thing about stories from the cell is deep. See, you be in the streets moving and grooving. You out here making your moves. You're doing your thing. Whatever, right? So when you in the streets, you like, damn. First of all, you think you're not going to get caught. I'm not getting caught. I'm just going to be the smartest criminal because people did crime before me, but they're not smarter than me. So I'm going to do some crime and I'm going to get away with it. I'm going to get rich. I'm going to do my thing. Bang. Once you get knocked in your head and you go down the county, you go through that stuff. You got to go through the preliminary hearing, all that stuff. You wind up going to trial, right? Then they knock you in your head. Send you upstate. Now you upstate. You went to trial. You feel as though it ain't a such thing as double jeopardy, but it seemed like it's double jeopardy because now, after you did 20, 15, 10 years, now you got to go to see the parole board and state your case all again. So, me, myself, I'm not even going to front. I got caught with some cell phones when I was in there. That's when I first got introduced to technology because in 2014, I had some cell phones. I got caught with some cell phones in my cell and all that stuff. I was at a little operation. I was doing my thing. But they wound up giving me...
Hold on, man. You got caught with some cell phones,
that's
bro.
It.
Fuck you, me. Yeah, I had a little operation.
He tried to make everything sound cool. You was locked up. Go ahead.
You was locked up. You had a fucking cell phone. You got caught.
I had some. It was more than that. But I'm not going to get into the grand scheme of things. But I will say this: once I got caught, check this out. I get caught. They give me a street charge and all that. Charge me again. Wind up getting a year inside of my whole sentence. They put another year on me, but it ran inside concurrent inside my sentence. So I didn't even. It didn't really matter. I go to the parole board now. The parole board, as soon as I go in, I'm like, damn, I'm going. You go over there with your folder. You're like, yeah, I'm ready to go home. You got all your plans. You ready to tell this grand story of what you're going to do when you get out. I go over there to Fruits. I go down there. I'm ready to lay my plans down. He said, excuse me. Yeah, Mr. Peebles, I see how you've been in the system for a long time. You first got arrested at the age of 11. Could you educate us on that? I'm not even expecting this.
Mm. You got to talk about some shit from all the way back then.
I'm not even expecting. So when you go to when you're in the streets and you operating, you don't know. There's so many different channels for you to make it back home. And just because you got a certain amount of time, you got five in Pennsylvania, you get a front time and a back time. 5 years, if you get a 5 to 10, 5 years the minimum time you got to do to go see the parole board, and 10 years is the maximum time you got to do. So if you come home, you got to walk that 5 years off on probation or whatsoever. But you still got to get permission to come home from the parole board. So now you'll be in there thinking anything cool, and they might tell you some shit like, oh, no, we don't like your attitude. We see you in another year. Come back again. Oh, no, you still ain't adjust your attitude. Because you got to go in there and say you done the crime even if you ain't do it. You got to, you don't want to accept responsibility? No, but I ain't shoot the cop. I was shooting a gun in the air, and the cop was running. It could be they not trying to hear shit. And it's however the police report was.
Right.
You might really be telling the real story of what happened, and they'd be like, oh, no, you trying to manipulate the system. I'm trying to manipulate the system. That's not how it is written down there. I'm telling you what really happened. Just because the police documented it that way, it don't mean. So I done seen dudes get year hit, 18 month hit, and they was really like, I told a real story of what happened. Everything my whole day. They get an 18 month hit, whatever. So at the end of the day, when you out here, you got a lot of obstacles to go through to make it back out in the streets when you out here doing dumb shit. So at the end of the day, you got to really be mindful because it costs, listen, and I keep telling people, it costs too much to be a criminal. I try to stress that to people because your family going to be out of a lot of money and time fucking with the system. It costs too much to be a criminal, man. And that parole board, it ain't no joke. I was blessed to get a 9 month hit and come back. And after that 9 month hit, wind up going to see a parole board and they let me go. You know what I mean? But a lot of people are not fortunate in that. And a lot of people don't have support out here to come home to. They may have a home plan to come home to. And a lot of people is coming home And during the time, their family died off, support system fell off, people went to jail, and they just stuck out here. Mm-hmm. So you got to be mindful when you're out here operating outside of law, whatever you're doing. Yo, youngins, whoever, grown men, think about this shit, man. The system is designed for you to go, stay, or come back.
And for the people that are just watching, maybe this is their first episode, you're on parole until when again?
2048.
So they just looking for you to fuck up.
No, not actually not. I ain't worried about that.
You, I mean, I know you not.
Yeah, but you know it is what it is. That's the reality.
But just for the system, that's the reality of my journey. That trap, yeah.
I did 20 years. If you don't know, I did 20 years in prison. Went there when I was 17. Came out 37 for some nut shit. So, you know, I just try to get these cats the game out here, you know, because everybody, everything teaches us to be a street nigga.
Right.
The music, everything, social media, like that's the most popular thing. That's how you're going to get the women. You're going to get the attention. You got to be cool. So I just try to warn people, like, listen, man, it costs too much to be a criminal. There's another ways to go.
Absolutely. So listen, man, we're going to get into this final segment. We're going to make this one kind of quick. I just wanted
like DJ Quick?
I just wanted to add one last question before we get out of here.
Okay.
Just everybody, if you had one last album, you can only keep one album to play for the rest of your life.
R&B, rap, rock.
Any album to play for the rest of your life, what album would it be?
Oh my God, how you gonna ask something like that?
I know, that's the purpose of it.
Damn, Dev, one album?
One album.
The last album on earth?
Last album on earth.
I think I know.
What?
I'm going with the best of Sade. Day. I got to.
A best of is cheating.
No, but I got to.
That's cheating. No, it's like not, a
it's
motherfucker.
Not, it's not, because if you're going with something like a Nas, It Was Written, or Jay-Z, Reasonable Doubt, that's a best of
but
album.
That's a cherry picking, bro. Like, you, that's all the best. Nah. You got to pick the album it came from.
So what you going with?
That's hard.
Actually, something. Lil Wayne, The Carter. Two.
not that one. Two.
Not the one?
Not one. Two.
You nut ass.
Not the one that Gil. This is the one after that. He learned a lot from Gil. Let me ask you something.
I want to hear what this weirdo
Gil,
hold on.
I got to ask something.
During whatever that turmoil was you kind of proud of the nigga when you heard?
No, Wayne is a thorough nigga, though.
No, that's, so you even know, back like, then, was like, you proud?
I feel like when Wayne dissed me, when he put out Problem Solver and he dissed me, I feel like Stunna had a lot to do with that.
Yeah. That's why I said I wondered if you was proud of it.
Yo,
like,
when
you
the last
it,
time you seen
proud.
Wayne? Like, y'all ain't seen each other?
I ain't seen Wayne in a minute. I seen Stunna, though.
How was y'all? It was a nice conversation. Y'all kicked
it. Yeah, I ran right up on him.
Yeah. It was cordial. Yeah, it was cordial, right?
That was what's up.
I think the last album I would be would have to be probably be some type of Tupac album.
Oh, yeah?
It wouldn't even matter.
All Eyes on Me. You talking about some type. You got to be one.
It could be Machiavelli. It could be All Eyes on
Me. You got to pick it,
you got to pick it. You got to pick it.
All Eyes on Me, then.
That's a cheat code. That's a cheat.
How?
How he cheated? He answered the question.
That's like a best of.
You fucking cheated, nigga.
That's what? Best of?
You said a best of. You can't do best ofs, nigga. That's a mixtape. A best of is a goddamn mixtape.
He didn't say that on it. He said the last album is an album.
Bro.
The best of album. The best of Sade. Legendary.
Nigga cheating.
Well, listen, I appreciate y'all tapping in this week and every week with us on $1 million worth of game.
Me.
I go by the name of Gillie the King.
And I'm Wallo 267.
And it's just like that.
Right.